Good morning. It's Friday. Yay. I'm going to do a little experiment. As you can see, I've taped off with painter's tape all around the perimeter of my pad. So I kind of want to do something that has a dark background, but I need to, it's real hard to get a dark background after you've already painted flowers and stuff. So I'm going to take this little spot and kind of fill it up around the edges with just like kind of a background color. So, but I want it dark because I want the flowers to stand out. So I'm going to mix a little black and a little blue and a little green. So I don't know, that might sound gross. Ooh, no, it's not. So I'm just going to kind of splash it on here. And I press the painter's tape down really hard. Hopefully it won't let much or any under the tape, because I want to have like a nice wide green mat. Or what am I talking about? A nice white surround. This isn't exactly as dark as I want it, but I get kind of stuck when the colors start to move a little, and then I don't want to go back, you know, like this. These are real nice. I don't want to go back and mess them up. So I don't really have any big idea of what I'm doing. Not that should be a big surprise.
There's my dog. There's my dog.
Right here, sometimes I'll let my brush just go a little bit dry, just for the texture. This is kind of cool because it's starting to dry, you know, all of this, but I like the way just very light flick of your wrist. I like those kind of brush strokes. And it seems, of course, I don't know, that could be just me. It seems like it takes a while to kind of develop that really easy flick of the wrist. So, let's see. Sometimes you just want to make marks, and mark making is a cool thing too. It kind of develops a pattern, although I don't really do it like consistently or anything. Okay, up here. I don't know. Not exactly sold on the purple, but so I'm gonna stick some kind of a golden yellow, only because I know it'll puddle up kind of like this. And okay, that's kind of what I was thinking about. Okay, that's really red. Oh, that's not the color. Thank you. I'm kind of liking it. Oops. It almost went from green to yellow, which I did not want to do. Okay, now I'm not positive here. So I'm going to let this bleed because I like it. And then I'm going to come back with a little blue and a little green and kind of do this stuff. Okay, so now I'm just going to do this and get some of this filled in, just not a lot of it. I don't want it to bleed everywhere, but I want to get out of having some of these white spots. And this is a little much. Well, I didn't want to do that. I think I'm going to put that back. Oh, nice. I just have my brush in water. Okay, so this is a little bit too soon, but I want to show you what it looks like after I peel the tape off. And hopefully, this is always the good part. Sort of. And you've got to be kind of careful, otherwise the tape will lift off a little bit of your paper, which you don't want that to happen. Oh shoot, that wasn't the last piece of tape. And this last piece. And so, there we are. Happy Friday.